Welcome to the Evergreen Indiana training for the 2015-2016 upgrade to Evergreen ILS version 2.9. The upgrade server maintenance window has been scheduled for 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, December 30, 2015, until 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, January 4, 2016. If possible, we will bring things back online ahead of schedule, so please watch the support listserv for updates on the server's availability. During the downtime, all three OverDrive consortia have been configured to be available for existing patrons. New patrons will not be able to register during the upgrade, but existing users will experience no interruption in service. Libraries are encouraged to prepare for the downtime by refreshing staff awareness of the offline standalone mode interface. Please note that in 2.7, the last receipt reprint functionality is non-operational. We recommend exporting a copy of your transactional data to maintain a backup of each day's activity if you wish to be doubly sure your data is available for upload on the 4th. Updates to My Account and the OPAC. Patrons will notice some changes to the My Account interface. First, up in the top right-hand portion of the screen, we have two new buttons, Messages and My Lists. Messages accesses the new message center and will flag to indicate that new messages are available for review. The My Lists button is a quick link to the My Lists interface to encourage increased use of this handy tool. The Account Summary tab now leads with the patron's account expiration date. We send out email notices and have internal notices in the staff client, but this will allow active patrons the opportunity to track their term of service at any point. The Patron Message Center. Beginning with Evergreen version 2.5, we've been able to post notes to the patron's My Account interface. They appeared as a static entry in the Patron's Account Summary tab, as shown. With our 2.9 implementation, no notes appear in the Account Summary, but clicking on either the new Messages button or tab will redirect the patron to the Message Center. New messages will appear as bolded links with dates and the library that issued the note. Patrons may click the box next to each message and select an action from the drop-down menu for batch operations. To view an individual message, they will click on the subject link. Messages may be marked as read, marked as unread, or deleted by the patron. Messages that are deleted by the patron will be retained in the staff client until the noting library chooses to remove it from the account. In Items Checked Out and Holds, patrons may sort the entries by clicking on the column header name. Entries appear by default by the date of the original hold or circulation. Here you can see circulations sorted by author instead. This ability to sort can be especially handy for patrons with long circulation histories or with a range of due dates so that relevant materials may be moved into groups for attention. My Lists may be sorted on title, author, or publication date only. Call number sorting is not an option at this time. In the catalog, patrons and staff will see a new link for the Bibliographic Records permalink. This link may be copied and distributed for citations or to direct other users to a specific record in the OPAC. Permalinks are streamlined for ease of use with no special symbols or filters. Circulation updates. Several new administrative settings have been introduced to prevent the creation of negative balances on patrons' accounts. The Patron Registration interface includes expired patrons in the possible duplicate search that is automatically performed. This functionality has been live for Evergreen Indiana libraries in 2.7, but was not announced formally to date. Staff should still perform patron searches to allow for nicknames and/or other name variants, including those created through typographical error. Book club organizers will rejoice to know there's a new link in the patron hold interface that allows staff to quick request multiple copies associated with a single bib record. This link appears once an initial hold on the record is placed successfully. This will not source copies from other bibliographic records, though, so be sure to target the records with the widest array of holdings when using this tool. You can access the Patron Message Center in the Other menu of the Patron interface. Entries are filtered by the Creating Org unit. To create a new message, click on Notes in the Other menu. Click on Add New Note, and make sure you click the box for Patron Visible. A new box appears for staff initials so the patron and staff know with whom to follow up in the event that additional information is required. Again, once created, a patron visible note will appear as a message in the My Account interface. Once read, the read time and date is populated in the staff client so you can see if the patron has viewed the message. It will also tell you if the patron chooses to delete the message, which may assist you in determining whether or not to delete the note in the client. Cataloging updates. If you have made arrangements with a vendor to include holdings information in your imported bibliographic records, the 852 may now be configured to include local StatCat data. If you wish to implement this, please contact the Help Desk for assistance in configuring your 852 settings with your vendor. Parts management has been updated to allow catalogers the option of deleting parts without losing historic parts data. This will allow for cleanup of parts which are no longer needed for active holdings while enabling continued accurate reporting of associated holdings. Parts merging has been extended to include mapping of holdings and parts during bibliographic record merges. This was a known issue in 2.7. If two bibliographic records were merged in the past, the parts associated with the non-lead record were hidden and the holdings appeared unmapped. This has been resolved, and merged bibliographic record parts will now appear correctly with their associated holdings. A new link appears in the OPAC record view called Clear Added Content Cache. What this does is force the system to query our added content vendor for an updated version of the item cover and associated added content, including reviews, read-alike recommendations, and series information. If you notice that an incorrect cover is appearing in the catalog and you can determine, based on the item in hand, that there is an error in the bibliographic record, whether a typo in the ISBN or lack of ISBN, for example, you are encouraged to update the record and use this new link to update the system with the correct cover and added content. Introducing the web client. Firstly, allow me to make clear that the web client is still in active development and not all functionalities are in place or will function as expected. The circulation module is mostly completed. The cataloging features are in early stages at this point. Libraries are encouraged to try out the available functions and see how a portable interface can be useful locally. The web client may be used on most web browser-enabled devices, including tablets and phones, though not all interfaces are fully optimized for small form screens. I would like to note that I personally had mixed results using the staff client hotkeys in the web client. My browser overrode some, but not all of them. Your luck may be better than mine. The first time you use the web client on any device, you will need to coordinate with your local admin to configure the associated workstation. Log in with the local admin account and go immediately to Administration. Select Workstation. Enter a name and click Register. The first workstation will automatically be set as the default, but additional workstations may be added as needed. This may be very useful for multi-branch system catalogers in particular. Configure the associated printers and printing templates as needed. We are not using Hatch, so please leave that unchecked. Please note that we have not skinned the testing server to match our staff client configuration, so the graphic interface may change over time. There are three main menus available. Search allows for patron, item, and catalog searching. Circulation contains a very familiar set of options, and I will walk you through a few of them in a moment. Cataloging has a full list of functions available in the menu, but cataloging is officially in beta, so functionality may be limited or unavailable ultimately. You will notice a new navigation feature throughout the interfaces on the web client. Pagination has been introduced to allow for faster data retrieval, as well as extended data sets where there have been fixed length data sets in the staff client. The first button will take you to the first page of entries. The forward and back buttons follow for paging. You can select how many rows you wish to view in a given page. You can jump to a specific page. And finally, the column picker, which allows for custom column configurations, is available as a simple arrow dropdown. Look for an added actions button in the page navigation section to see what options there are for working with the data on a given page. Many functions have been converted to buttons or new subtabs rather than menu options, though, so you may have to look around the page to discover your new workflow. Back to the available circulation functions. Select Checkout from the menu, splash page, or by using the F1 hotkey. Scan the patron barcode as usual. You will note that the interface preloads the tabs for checking out, items out, holds, bills, messages, edit, other, and patron search. Once you've scanned the barcode, the patron summary appears and you can move through the interface tabs as expected. To minimize the patron summary, you click on the two arrows graphic rather than the framing sidebar, which shows up in the staff client. Please note there are fewer menu options under Other than are currently available in the staff client. In the web client, you will see normalized titles and authors, which means that everything will appear in lowercase. You can, however, click on titles or barcodes and be taken immediately to the bibliographic record or item details screen from most interfaces. There is no separate message center in the web client at this point, but you can view and delete notes just as in the staff client notes interface. The differently colored headers have been eliminated in the web client, so be careful if you normally use them as a quick reference for available actions. The Holds pull list has a new column called Potential Copies, which you can use to help determine the priority of getting your own available copy captured and provided to the patron. In this example, you can see that the library owns the only copies in the consortium for the first two bibliographic records. If you discover that your copy is missing or damaged, this will allow you to decide whether to retarget, transfer the hold to another bibliographic record, or notify the patron immediately that the hold may not be filled and thereby reduce wait times. The patron registration form has not been changed in the web client. Item status has a new header of scan item, but retains both the detailed and list views for entries. There are no actions available at this point, as this is still in development with the cataloging module. Searching the catalog doesn't feel much different than using the OPAC or staff client, but the views are handled a bit differently. You'll notice a row of tabs above the Search the Catalog line. Once a search is completed and a record selected, you can begin moving between these tabs to see the many cataloging views of the record. Mark Edit is a bit rough right now, but there are some interesting new buttons at the top for overlaying, volume transfer, and conjoined items, which were formerly menu options. By putting the buttons at the top of this view, catalogers may find their workflows are more streamlined. Mark View is consistent with that in the OPAC or staff client as a simple text view with no special functions. View Holds has quick buttons for transferring holds between records and, like the Holds pull list, information on potential copies. Monograph Parts is an exact match for the staff client at this point. The Holdings view has no special buttons, but an action menu is available. There are multiple views of the patron search form. The initial default is a quick search by name only. Click on the circled down arrow button to access the full search form. As in the staff client, a list is populated and individual record summaries may be viewed. The major difference is that the search boxes remain on your screen until you move to the patron record rather than being hidden behind the patron summary as in the staff client. Also coming soon are the OverDrive record integration and revised short name schema. The OverDrive content is scheduled to appear the first week in January 2016. The short name update will take a bit longer to populate across the database. More information will be released on a target rollout for that very shortly.